Hey SwiftUI enthusiasts, get ready to turbocharge your SwiftUI skills because in today's video, I'm unleashing 10 SwiftUI one-liners that are absolute dynamite. Yep, you heard that right. Complex layouts, navigation, all packed into just one line of code each. Whether you're a SwiftUI newbie or a seasoned pro, these one-liners are about to take your game to a whole new level. So, if you're up to some coding magic, keep watching as I unravel these 10 SwiftUI one-liners. Let's dive in. So let's dive into my 10 all-time favorite one-liners in SwiftUI, and make sure you check out the end of this video because there's a bonus one. This video is sponsored by me. Rebeloper.com/mentoring is where you want to go if you want to meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. Again, it's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So what I have done here is just open up a brand new Xcode project, and let's dive into our first one-liner, and that is a state. Yeah, it's as simple as that. One of my all-time favorite one is earth state. So the earth state property wrapper. So earth state private var is presented, for example, equals false. Now, this is such a powerful property wrapper because think of it like it's a bucket where you add in values over time. Of course, it can have its default value. Otherwise, it could be an optional, but yeah, this is the way you should initialize it. And over time, these values will be updated and the UI will automatically update itself according to this published state variable. And this is so, so amazing. So let's go into our second one. Yeah, I'm going to build this out as we go. Our second one is SF symbol. So we have a system name globe right over here. And what we can do here, let me just build and run, is just use all of these SF symbols. So you just go image system name globe. And this is how it looks like. You can see just a globe, or we could just choose one from our library. So make sure you select this one. And of course you can just scroll through or type in some, let's just go with a plus maybe. Let's just go speaker.plus. Let's build and run. And this is SF symbols image of type system name. It's really, really powerful. And you can customize it to your needs. It's amazing. Level up your SwiftUI game with rebeloper.com/mentoring. My mentoring program is tailor-made for SwiftUI devs just like you. Get ready for hands-on learning, expert guidance, and practical skills that will make your app shine. Whether you're crushing UI design or mastering animations, I have your back. Ready to dominate the SwiftUI scene? Join me at rebeloper.com/mentoring and let's skyrocket your SwiftUI skills together. Now, number three is sheet backgrounds. So for that, I'm going to use another type of image. I have already added this asset right over here. So I'm going to copy out its name. So let's copy that out. And let's add that image into our content view. So let's have this image and let's just put that in there, and let's make this resizable, and that's it. I'm also going to remove the padding, why not? Let's build and run and see how this looks like. It's going to stretch it out. Shortest SwiftUI course also. This is the tallest thumbnail that I have ever seen. Now, this is fine. This is just for us to see an image. Now, what we are going to do is present a sheet. So let's create a new file right over here. And that will be a SwiftUI view. Let's name this detail view. And let's name this hello detail view. And let's present that sheet. So what we're going to do is add maybe a button right over here with a title of maybe sheet, and then the action. Well, we are going to toggle on the is presented. So is presented toggle, and let's add our sheet right over here. Sheet with the is presented and content. Let's bind that is presented. And the content, of course, is our detail view. Okay, so we have set this up. We have our sheet right over here. It's just going to pop up, but this is nothing to do with the sheet background that I'm talking about. Well, now you can set that up. So let's just have a presentation. Let's see, background, and let's have maybe ultra thin material. Let's just see how that looks like. And this, with this one line of code, this is so amazing. Let's present that sheet right over there. And you see, it's brilliant. It's just one line of code. Also, number four is presentation details. Now, this has been a while in the SwiftUI library. You just go presentation details on the actual view that you are presenting inside the sheet, of course, and then you can have an array of presentation details. It could be lead, medium, large, custom fraction, or just a set height. Let's just go for medium and then dot large, so you can see what I mean. And the first, we are going to present the sheet only halfway up. That's the medium. So let's click over here, as you can see, it's just halfway up. It's the medium detent. And if you just slide all the way up, that's the large one. You can just slide all the way down. It's amazing. And that is presentation detent. Now, we have talked about sheets. The next, and this is so undervalued, it is the new navigation link. So let's put our content view into a navigation stack. Just a simple navigation stack, no path, nothing too fancy today. We are going to navigate to our detail view. And yeah, let's just remove our image and also our sheet, why not? So let's have a navigation link. And there are a few over here, but the overlooked one, and I believe one of the most powerful one, is this one with the destination and label, or title key destination, whatever you see right. Let's just use the one with the title key and destination. So the title key will be our detail view. There we go. And the destination, of course, the detail view. Let's just build and run. And you have a navigation link that is going to the detail view. It's so, so powerful. It's really, really amazing. Next up is list row separator. And what I mean by that, we can hide now the list row separator. So let's just create a simple list right over here. So let's add some data to our list. Let's have a state private var data equals. And let's have an array of the names. So Adam, and then maybe Bob, not, and Claire. Plus one for that person who is going to comment down below why I chose Ada. So Ada is our first one, Bob and Claire. So they are unique. Therefore, the data can be added inside the list. And yeah, I'm going to remove all of this and let's have a list right over here. Inside that list, we are going to have a for each with the data of data. And the ID will be self. Self, there we go. And then we are going to get back a name in and then put that name into a text. There we go. Simple as that. It's just a simple list with some data. There we go, Ada, Bob, and Claire. Really, really nice. But I don't want to see these list row separators. Therefore, I'm just going to add it in here. So dot list row separator visibility, and the visibility is going to be set to hidden. Let's see how that looks like. There we go, now it's hidden. So I can use any type of view and also use the advantages of list. For example, the scroll view does not have an on delete and also it's really, really, those animations are much, much nicer inside the list. But still we have this default list style. There we go. This is number seven, list style of plain. So let's just add this list style of dot plain. As you can see, there are quite a lot right over here, but I'm just going to use the plain one because it's That's what I want. I want full control. And now I can just do whatever I want with these cells and also have the power of lists. And next up with styles is my favorite on button style. So let's take this out and let's have a V-stack over here and let's have a button with a title of tap me and whatever action, it doesn't really matter. And we are focusing on UI now. You see, it has the accent color and currently the default accent color is blue. But maybe I want to have this to be black or whatever, you know, the tint color of whatever string I add in here, or maybe we could just use the other initializer with the action and label. We don't care about the action right over here. Therefore, we just add a text and tap me, and maybe we just add a bold right over here. So you can see we added some custom text and it's still blue. Well, the accent color. What we can do is just use our button style of plain. So again, we are removing any style from the button. There we go. We have tap me as a black one. Of course, you can customize your label to your needs. Okay, next up on the list is number 9. And that is the spacer. So spacer is really, really fun because I can push around some views. So if I add a spacer right over here, it's going to push up our button. And if I just move the spacer all the way up there, it's just going to push down our button. As simple as that, of course. But what if I added a color right over here? Let's just have a color of a dot red. Why not? Okay, so now it's going to push down the color, but because the color is a push out view, we are not really going to see this. What we should do is, to illustrate my point, is move this into horizontal stack, and then the spacer is going to try to push the color. But because the color is a push out view, it's just going to take up as much space as it can, and it's going to have this spacer right over here with a default length. And my point here with the spacer, if you don't want that default length right over here, just the minimum, then you want to use the initializer with the spacer minimum length. If you set this to nil, it's just going to use that default set. And if you set this to 0, it's just going to allow the color red to push it all the way to the length of 0. Now, with the color, it doesn't really make sense, but think of this, maybe you have a long text and you want to have a spacer between those. So yeah, make sure that you do use spacer too. Finally, number 10, that is overlay. So let's just have let's go to our V-stack back and let us have a text right over here. And that text will say hello, why not? So let's add an overlay over here. So the overlay, we can have content, alignment and content. This is my favorite with alignment and content. So let's choose this one. And default one is center. So I'm just going to choose center for now. And the content, well, let's just have a circle and let's have this frame of width of, 44 and height 44. And also let's have a foreground style, because now foreground color has been, you know, renamed to foreground style of color dot red. Color, there we go, color dot red. So now we should see that dot right over there. Well, let's just make this a little bit smaller so we can actually see the hello text. There we go, it's right over there. But now that I have the alignment, it's really, really super cool. I can just add this wherever I want. Maybe I want to have it top trailing. Why not? As maybe a badge, you know, it's right over there. It's so, so fun. Of course, sometimes you don't want to have the overlay actually on the text, because this text is a push a pull in view, you want to make it a push out view. So my bonus tip is how to create a push out view. You saw the actually color is a push out view, it's trying to take up as much as it can. The text is a pull in view. Now let's make this hello a push out view, so this circle will be all the way on top on our screen. So how can we do that? Well, we want to put this into a Z stack. Okay, a Z stack right over there. And we want to set the color of clear over there. That's as simple as that. Let me just hit Control I over here so we can indent all of this. Let's build and run. Let's see this. There we go. Now you have it right over here. But this is not a one-liner you might add. Well, let's make it. So let's create an extension view, and let's create a function. Let's just call this as push out view. Okay, and this will actually return some view. Okay, so let's just copy this part out and put it over there. Of course, the text, we don't need that text. It will be self, because we have here an extension of our view. So now let's just grab our view text hello world, just place it over there. And just a second, so I can highlight this better. There we go. And now I'm just going to say dot as push out view, and let's indent that overlay. Okay, let's see if we got the same effect. And again, now this will be a one-liner. There it is. Those are my 10 SwiftUI all-time favorite one-liners and this bonus one. And if you want to learn about Firebase authentication, how it's done right in SwiftUI, go ahead. The video is right over here.